So the facility here, to explain it very simply, is to call it an incinerator. And it's 240 tons per day.
まだそんなにたくさんないんですが、飯舘村の家屋をですね、壊してるんですよ。もう戻らないとか、それから古い、家がたくさんあるんで、それを壊してっていう時に廃材が出るわけですね。それを焼却するとかという形でですね。
And so what is brought here for using, it's a lot of, you know, the old houses and so on that people will not be coming back to, you know, the building materials or the wooden frames from houses and this sort of thing, because they're sort of, you know, deconstructing these homes that people will not return to. And they're brought here for incineration, so the you know, wooden frames and materials and so on from the homes.
総工費420億円.
And it's a... 42 billion yen that was used to construct this.
5年間の仮設です。
And it's thought to be used for 5 years.
なんでこんな山の中に、実はメーカーもですね、国もですね、安全ですって、大丈夫ですって言ってるんですが、ご覧いただいた通り、実は、村の境から22キロ奥まったこんなところに作るというよりも、原発が安全だからって福島に作ったのと同じです。安全じゃない危険があるからこんな山の中に持ってきたんです。
And so, well, the maker of the facility and also the government, you know, they say, oh, well, it's safe, you know, what's being burned here, what's coming out of here, there's no impact, it's safe. However, when you look at where it's being built, the fact that it's built here, you know, 22 kilometers away from where the nearest, you know, people are, it's way out in the hills and so on, that shows that in reality, you know, it's not the case. The same way as we were always told that nuclear power plants are safe as well.
そんな程度なんですが、もし質問があります。つい最近、オープニングはですね、昨年末ですけど、
And this was just opened at the end of last year.
正式に動き始めたのはつい最近です。
And it just started operating very, very recently.
なんか見せしようとしてるんですよ。ほとんど出ないと 99.99% 回収できるとは言っていますけども、ちょっと一概には信じられませんね。
And so according to the Japanese government, the smoke coming out of these incinerators, they say that 99.99% of the cesium is trapped inside the facility, so it's filtered so it doesn't come out, is what the government tells us.
75% が山林になっているんですね。で、今回の汚染については山林は除染対象になっていないんです。道路から約20メーターくらいまではというふうになってるんですが、で 75% の山林が除染されないということでですね、この辺にあるモニタリングポストそのものはあまりその本来のモニタリングの意味をなさないというようなことなんですね。というのは村民にとってはですね、実は生活圏って環境省は、宅地と農地が生活圏だっていうふうに言うんですが、村民にとってはですね、山も生活圏なんですよ。先ほど言いましたように、山菜取ったりキノコ取ったりっていうこと。
75% of the land around here is forest. And actually, within the decontamination that's going on now, as we said, it's only the first 20 meters of the forest area which is being decontaminated, and the rest of the mountains are not being touched at all. And according to the Ministry of Environment, which is responsible for
際にですね、山林の除染はですね、私自身もやるべきではないと思っています。というのは除染そのものが自然破壊そのものなんですが、特に山林の場合にはですね、表面の腐葉土とその下5センチを取ると99% のセシウムは回収できることは分かっています。ただそれを取って雨が降るたんびにですね、土砂崩れが起こるわけです。土質がですね、花崗岩の砂礫層なので非常に脆いんですね、雨に。
Whether the decontamination in the forest areas should be done or not, Mr. Ito actually doesn't think that this should happen. And the reason for this is the decontamination itself is destroying the environment. And so while it might be clear that if the first 5 centimeters was taken away, you might be able to get rid of 99% of the CCM, which is in the soil. But at the same time, that makes the ground of the soil so weak and vulnerable as well. So you know, rain falls as well, landslides, and so on.
その時にですね、300数十箇所 の, 崩壊決あの決壊が起きています。
And in September of last year, actually there was very, very heavy rainfall in the village. And at that time, in more than 300 places throughout the village, actually there was those sorts of things seen with the landslide.
So, ここから先がですね、右側にですね、仮置き場と言われる村全体では140ヘクタールなんですけど、ここで一番大きなですね、40ヘクタール、実は山の中にも、この裏にもあってですね、見えるのはこの一部です。右側にも住んでありますね。
Wow.
You can see on the right here.